It was Hayao Miyazaki, founder of Studio Ghibli, who said, "You must see with eyes unclouded by hate. See the good in that which is evil, and the evil in that which is good. Pledge yourself to neither side, but vow instead to preserve the balance that exists between the two." One of my friends was amazed that I'd never seen any Studio Ghibli films, so he took me on a crash course and I was blown away. Every story is so beautifully crafted, so simple yet so profound, and it really hits a chord and brings out memories from childhood. Miyazaki makes a different kind of movie to Disney. While most Disney stories are about good prevailing over evil, the hero conquering the villain, Miyazaki thinks such a strategy is rotten. His stories focus on the good and the bad, and the little line in between. He sees beauty that exists in the world as well as the evil, and tells stories that show both hope and despair. One of the reasons I enjoyed Studio Ghibli films so much was because it gave me a feeling I haven't felt in a long time, the feeling of watching a Disney film as a kid, like The Lion King for the first time. The Lion King is richly drawn and beautifully animated, and at its core it tells a really emotional story that taught me a lot about life and loss, about coming of age, and the film borrows themes from Hamlet to African mythology. However, something that struck me was the present difference between the two studios. While Studio Ghibli continues to release brilliant and original classics, all of my fond memories of amazing Disney films come from my childhood. Why is this? We've got to look a little bit deeper. Welcome to the Film Essay. The first question I think it's necessary to ask is what Disney films are to be considered classics. Obviously, this is up to the interpretation of the viewer, but in looking over the records, I've compiled what I believe to generally be the classic Disney films. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, Pinocchio, one of my personal favourites, Fantasia, Dumbo, Bambi, Cinderella, Peter Pan, The Lady and the Tramp, 101 Dalmatians, The Jungle Book, The Little Mermaid, Aladdin, The Lion King, Pocahontas, Mulan, Tarzan, Lilo and Stitch, and, although it pains me to admit it, I guess Frozen would have to be considered a classic too. Since the 1930s, Disney has been churning out at least three critically acclaimed and publicly loved films every decade, apart from a 20-year blip during the 70s and 80s. But recently, something has changed. Instead of making films that can be considered classics of our generation, Disney has done a U-turn and seems to be working their way through their old filmography, giving everything a fresh, shiny coat of CGI. Ironically, Robert Iger, the current CEO of Disney, said, "The riskiest thing we can do is maintain the status quo." And yet this is what each film does, maintains the status quo. As Danny Placido writes for Forbes, "The film industry is a democracy, and we all vote with cinema tickets. We seem to want to take a trip back into childhood, however brief, and see our memories reconstructed in glossy photorealism." But is this a good thing? I don't think it is. Firstly, these remakes are almost shot-for-shot remakes. Very little originality has been added to Beauty and the Beast, or The Jungle Book, or Dumbo, and very little will be added to The Lion King, no doubt. What's more, the little originality that is added takes away from the stories that we hold dear to us, making the near-perfect stories worse rather than adding to them. Secondly, while there is a charm to 2D drawings that is timeless, CGI is doomed to age badly. These live-action remakes look glossy now, but in decades when computer animation has got infinitely better, the charm won't remain. Bambi was made in 1941, and it still looks charming today. This is because of its 2D, hand-drawn animation. So now, let's turn our attention to Studio Ghibli. What are they doing that's so different? Well, firstly, their commitment to originality has never wavered. Despite films like Spirited Away having a cult classic status in the view of critics and audiences alike, Studio Ghibli won't announce a Spirited Away 2 or remake it with glossy animation. If anything, as Disney strays further from originality and its meticulously hand-drawn origins, Studio Ghibli further embraces it. In 2016, they released a hand-drawn, minimalist film entitled The Red Turtle. A film without any dialogue, the beautiful scenery and profound story is made as a minimal canvas that the viewer is invited to place meaning upon. And it's beautiful as a result. It pains me to say it, but Disney is taking the cheap route. Disney wants to give viewers the same profound feeling it used to, and instead of working to achieve that feeling like Studio Ghibli does, by encouraging originality and crafting films with love and passion, Disney have worked out that they can get a similar feeling through the nostalgia of its audience by telling exactly the same story. Hayao Miyazaki rides this beautiful line between fantasy and reality, stressing the sensitivity of the human condition. It finds beauty in simplicity, and though Miyazaki has sadly passed away now, his legacy lives on in the beautiful films the studio continues to create. I have faith in Disney's ability to get back its past glory, but the sad truth is, as an incredibly profitable production company, it's going to continue with these remakes until it stops making so much money off them. Either way, while the history of brilliant animation rests heavily on Disney's shoulders, at least there's a studio carrying this brilliance forward, moving us with touching, beautiful, original ideas. Thank you, Studio Ghibli.